Okay, so we're going to continue working some homework problems and similar problems from Faires and DeFranza. The first two problems are on page 20, and the next three problems are associated to problems similar to there. The first problem says to sketch or give the equation of the circle of radius 3 that has center 0, 2. The second one says to give the equation of the circle of radius 4 with center negative 1, 4. Of course, we're going to sketch the graphs. And I'm going to show you how to use the techniques of completing the squares to sketch the graphs of these three circles as well. Okay, so in number 24, since we know the radius is 3 and we know the center, then the form that we're going to put this in is x minus h quantity squared plus y minus k quantity squared is equal to the radius squared. Here, h is equal to 0, that's the x displacement. K is equal to 2, that's the y displacement. And our radius is equal to 3, so this is an easy problem. Then we just want to write x squared plus y minus 2 quantity squared is equal to 3 squared, that's 9. Now let's go ahead and sketch the graph of this. The center of the circle is at 0, 2, so the center of the circle is here. The radius is 3, so the circle is going to land down below there. I'm going to get in the way of the picture for a moment. There's my circle, and observe that we can indeed compute the intersection of this circle with both the x and y axis. I'm going to go ahead and find these four intersection points. It doesn't take much time. The x-intercepts occur when y is equal to 0. When y is equal to 0, we get x squared plus 0 minus 2 quantity squared is equal to 9. So x squared plus 4 is equal to 9. So x squared is equal to 5, or x is equal to plus or minus the radical of 5. So those points are just a little bit beyond plus or minus 2. And the y-intercepts occur when x is equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, we have y minus 2 squared is equal to 9. The square is already complete, so you just need to take the square roots. We get y minus 2 is equal to plus or minus 3, or y is equal to 2 plus or minus 3. Now, when you first see that expression, that looks a little bit strange, but it means 2 plus 3, that would be 5, or 2 minus 3, minus 1. So this point of intersection is going to be 5, this point of intersection is going to be minus 1. Now let's work the circle of radius 4 with center at negative 1, 4. We'll plug into that same form. Remember, it's x minus h squared plus y minus k squared is equal to r squared. Whenever you're trying to learn a formula, always write the formula down every time you use it. You have x plus 1 squared plus y minus 4 squared is equal to our radius squared, which is 4 squared. So x plus 1 squared plus y minus 4 squared is equal to 16. Sketching the graph, we have the center is at negative 1, 4. The radius is 4. And so the circle, well, the circle is up there somewhere. The x intercepts are when y is equal to 0. When y is equal to 0, we get x plus 1 squared plus minus 4 squared is equal to 16. So x plus 1 squared is equal to 0. So x is equal to minus 1. That's why that circle is tangent at that point. And I have just enough room to compute the y-intercepts. The y-intercepts occur when x is equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, I get 1 squared plus y minus 4 squared is equal to 16. So y minus 4 squared is equal to 15. Y minus 4 is equal to plus or minus the radical of 15. So y is equal to 4 plus or minus the radical of 15. One y-intercept is very small, that's 4 minus the radical of 15, and the other y-intercept is up here somewhere.
You have the square root of 5 right there?
Square root of 15. Thank you. Okay. And so those are those two intersections. Now let's look at completing the square. The first problem that I wrote down was x squared minus 4x plus y squared plus 2y is equal to 5. And what we want to do is we want to group our x terms together, group our y terms together. We want to think about x squared minus 4x is the area of a rectangle x by x minus 4. We want to think about y squared plus 2y is the area of a rectangle y times y plus 2. Each area of each rectangle can be expressed as a difference of two squares. I encourage you to look at the completing the square videos to see how that works. And what we do is we take the x down, we take the sign down, we divide 4 by 2, then we rewrite the 2 over here. We take the sign down, the plus down, divide 2 by 2, we get 1, and then rewrite the 1 over here. So our completed square form becomes x minus 2 squared minus 4 plus y plus 1 squared is minus 1 is equal to 5. So x minus 2 squared plus y plus 1 squared is equal to 5 plus 1 plus 4. And that gives me 10. So we have a circle of radius square root of 10 centered at the point 2, negative 1. So we go over 2, negative 1, circle of radius 10, centered at that point. And as before, we can compute the intercepts. But I think we'll stop here for that one, and then we'll return to the other two circles.